Hi Sagittarians, welcome back to my channel. This is the Sacred Sun Tarot and you're watching the November month reading for Sagittarius Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs. Let's see what's coming up towards you in the month of November and what are the true intentions of the person you're dealing with in the month of November. So here we go. Let's see what's up with the Sagittarians. Guys, do hit the subscribe button to stay updated with the videos. And do write down in the comment section below how this reading resonates with you. Also, for private readings, find my information in the contact details given in the description box. Let's get started and see what's coming up for Sagittarians. So this is for Sagittarians. Okay, so this person in the past, chose to stay independent. And you were healing from a connection, you were healing from something in the past. But past is heavily on your mind right now and this person is juggling. We'll see, we'll clarify each and every card and we'll see what's up with the Sagittarians. Okay, so what are the true intentions of this person? Temperance, healing, they're juggling. And you want some cycles to come to an end. Yeah, King of Cups, see. You want the major cycles to come to an end and you want some new things to begin. Please clarify this Nine of Pentacles in the past. Why this person was loving their independence? Queen of Pentacles. Can be an earth sign you were dealing with? Yeah. So, can be an earth sign you were dealing in the past. And this can be a Virgo individual, very strong Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn vibe, can be Leo also. So this person found financial independence, or this person found independence of some sort, financial, emotional, or they found their freedom actually. Maybe you came out of a connection with somebody, you stopped talking to this person, something happened. And this person found their happiness, their independence. And I see this person growing financially. Maybe they started growing financially when you were not talking to them, or they got a new job, they got into new, Yeah, so what I see here, in the past of this person found their financial independence. They were in a very nurturing environment maybe. And this person learned to hold back. Maybe in the beginning, in the past, you both were in a very good connection. But the second you stopped talking to this person, I guess you stopped talking to this person, or maybe this person backed out. But they found their independence. And because of that, they started holding back. They started resisting you. And they found strength within themselves. Please clarify this Four of Swords here. The Magician and the Three of Cups. You tried manifesting with something with this person. When you were healing, when this person was actually independent, I guess you both, if this was a past relationship, you both got separated, you both went through a divorce, or maybe there was a separation between you both. During that time period, while you were healing, while you were resting, and while you were gaining your energy back, this person found their independence into something else. And I don't see a third party. I simply see this person was working on themselves. And I simply see that this person was majorly... The time you were away from this person found their happiness. And you were healing from something. And I guess the second you came out of this break, the second you came out of this healing time period, you wanted to reconcile with this person. You wanted to manifest some connection, some sort of connection again with this person, which I guess right now we'll try to find out what is the current situation here. But in the past, I feel that this you wanted reconciliation after a break, and this person is holding back. this person is probably in the past, this person was not willing to come back to you easily. This person is juggling right now. They are confused. Please, okay, to take a leap of faith. And what is the other thing here? Sun. What is the Six of Cups here? The Emperor, the Ten of Cups. Okay, so you're acting quite stubborn right now, I guess. You're missing the past heavily. You feel that this person was your soulmate. You really want to get into a connection with this person. You miss them a lot. But you're very stubborn here. You're very controlling your acting. You're controlling your emotions maybe. And you're finding ways to take back control of the situation. You really want to take back control of the situation. And you want to find your Ten of Cups here. You see this person as your soulmate, Sagittarians. But what this person is doing, they are juggling. This person is very confused. On one hand, this person knows that you are their happiness. This person loves to be with you. This person loves to be with you. They enjoy with you. They feel like a child with you. And on the other hand, this person loves your freedom as well. This person is feeling that, I don't know, I'm getting a vibe that despite of so much love, this person feels that getting into a connection with you or getting into a relationship with you can be a lot of work, can be a lot of effort, as well as, getting into a connection with you can result into some sort of, how should I say, stuckness? This person might lose their freedom if they get into a connection with you. I'm getting that vibe, I don't know. This person feels that if they get into a connection with you, though they know that you are their happiness and they want to be with you, that's why maybe they are juggling, because for you, they will have to sacrifice their independence. They will have to sacrifice their freedom, and they're probably not willing to do that. That's why they're healing. They're waiting for something. Maybe they're not answering. At heart, the world, you're telling this person that overall that I want to have this connection with you. I want to have this relationship with you. And you want to have a very strong connection with this person. But at heart, what you're doing? Let's find out. What are you doing at heart? Four of Wands. Nine of Swords, yes. I think you want to start a new cycle with this person. You want to tell them, okay, let's leave what has been left in the past behind. Let's close all the chapters of the past, because I do feel you shared a very strong past with this person. And you want to close the chapters of the past and you want new things. You want to rush into a commitment. You want to deliver news towards them. You want them to know that they want this connection with you. You want this connection with them. You want this Four of Wands with them. You want this family home situation with them. What is this Temperance here? Please clarify this Temperance. Eight of Swords. Yeah, this person is stuck. This person feels that getting into a connection with you might result in some sort of financial stuckness or financial... financially, I feel that this person thinks that getting into a connection with you might constrain them financially. This person wants to be with you. I get that way. But this person feels that getting into a connection with you will result in their financial dependence of some sort. Or maybe the freedom they have right now, the enjoyment they have right now, they might feel stuck financially. Please give me an outcome here for the month of November for Sagittarians. The Emperor, yes, see the Emperor and the Emperor. So you are not going to be easy with this person. I don't see you being melting down, or I see a very stubborn energy at your part. You want a new family, you want a new relationship. Maybe you're telling this person that either by hook or crook, I want my happiness, I want my Ten of Cups. So either with you or with somebody else, but I see very controlling energy. I think you're not going to compromise on something. This person wants you, maybe this person wants you to compromise in something, but you're not going to do that. Please clarify this emperor here. The page of pentacles, the devil, and the high priestess, the judgment. I do feel that somebody is coming towards you with this offer, or maybe you are going towards somebody with an offer. You really want to connect to this person. I do feel, see, ace of cups. And this is clear in your mind, maybe, that either you or anybody else, but I want my 10 of cups. You know, some very stubborn hook or crook energy, my way or highway sort of attitude I can see here in somebody. This can be you, this can be the other person. Just see which side resonates with you. But I think somebody is going with an offer to somebody. But there's a devil in between. Maybe this controlling behavior right now is a devil. Somebody is getting a negative, toxic attitude being developed. Something negative is coming out. Some devilishness, actually somebody's hiding this devilish capacity. If you're going towards this person, this can be a situation where this person is keeping secrets about a third party. This person is keeping a secret about a toxic situation which they don't want to tell you. One situation is possible. This is not true for everybody. Maybe this person is earning money through devilish means, through toxic means. See, if not toxic means, then something which is illegal, something which is not accepted by the society maybe, or something which is not in the correct manner. They can be. This is not true for everybody. This can be true for some people, of course. But I guess that maybe this person is attached to something which is not legal, or which is not ethical, something like that. And this person wants to keep quiet because this person is loving their freedom. They're getting a lot of money, or they're getting a lot of satisfaction from that thing, whatever this toxic thing is. And they don't want to leave it because they feel stuck here. They want their finances. They're just watching their finances growing and they don't want to get stuck here. Maybe you are telling them that whatever this wrong means you're following right now, you will have to end it if you want a connection with me. Maybe you're very stubborn, you're asking them to leave all this, but they feel this person is acting a little foolish. They feel that whatever they're doing is good. They're rising, they're growing. They do feel happy with you, but they don't want this growth to come to an end. This can be a third party situation. Maybe they're dealing with a third party situation where they're feeling some toxic ways, they're getting addicted to some toxic ways, and that's why they don't want to leave it. But I don't see any third party as such. I feel that this person is addicted to something which is unethical, which is toxic, and they are earning money, or maybe they're getting something out of this toxic connection. And this is quite devilish. So you might go to them and ask them about leaving their ways and starting over new with you, because I do see that you want to settle down with this person. But I guess this person is keeping quiet for time being. This person is not answering. I don't see as such. And I think you're very clear in your mind. You feel that I want to get into a relationship. I want a stable partnership. If you are ready to come with me, well and good. We'll start a new family, we'll start a new home, we'll start a new relationship. But if you're not ready, please go your way, because I want my stability in my life. If not you, then I'll find somebody else. But I guess you're not going to compromise with whatever negativity this person is showing to you right now. But definitely you want to offer something to this person. But you're not going to accept the negative ways, the toxic ways this person is bringing towards you. And I do feel that this person is hiding some things from you. If you're not aware of the toxicity this person is having right now, I do feel this person is hiding something. So be aware and get through the background checks, whatever this thing is going on, whatever they're doing right now. Just get your background checked before you actually walk up to this person and offer something to them. Thank you so much for watching this reading. Do hit the subscribe button to stay updated with the videos, and do write down in the comment section below how this reading resonates with you. Also, for those who want to have private readings with me, just find my contact details in the description box. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.